So, another episode of Keeping It Real, and I got to say, here's a disclaimer. It's been a while since we've done one of these, and I'm hoping that thousands of people have missed the show. And if you have, we're back. And today's episode is all about our senior centers in Carroll County. Now, I wanted to do this because there's always a thought about what senior centers are, and I think there's probably a thought about what they aren't more so than what they are. So I wanted to cover this today, and I've got two special guests with me, and I'm going to start with Patty because Patty has been involved with the senior population in Carroll for, gosh, years, and it's something that we put a lot of energy to, and you guys do a tremendous job. And Celine came onto the scene not too long ago, but I'll let you introduce her, okay. And we'll go from there. So, Patty Whitson, good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to Keeping It Real in Carroll.
Thank you.
Patty, your official title.
I am the Community Services Supervisor. One of my duties is overseeing the 5 senior centers in Carroll County.
Okay, so there's the first trivia question right. That's been answered.
There are five
senior centers in Carroll County.
Yes.
And Celine is, Patty, you want to introduce Celine? We'll
make Celine this. Celine is our Bureau Chief. She's been here 1 year.
Right.
So we are.
But Celine's
really
been with the county more than 1 year. Let's be clear.
Yes.
But she scooted over to you, and I don't know that I've gotten over that yet, but that's fine. We kept her talent, which is the most important thing. So Celine, good morning to you too.
Good morning.
And how are you enjoying your year?
It has been a wonderful year. I can't believe it's passed already. It went by very quickly. Still learning a lot and very excited about the services that we offer through the Bureau of Aging and Disabilities.
So HR to aging.
HR to aging.
There's probably a joke there. Yeah, let's just let it go. So, there are 5 senior centers.
5 senior centers.
Patty, and where are they?
Westminster, North Carroll, South Carroll, Tawny Town, and Mount Airy.
And all of them are self-contained, their own buildings.
They are.
And let me point out that we're sitting in the library of the Tawny Town Senior Center today for a couple of reasons. Number one, there's a celebration going on here today for the manager that has retired. And number two, it's in my district. So I wanted to, you know, to point out that it's a gem here in Tawny Town.
It is. We have 5 very wonderful senior centers, and we need to thank the commissioners because they're wonderful, because you have given us such wonderful buildings to operate out of. We have about 5,000 people that are registered in the senior centers in 16. And 1,300 new registrations last year, 100 here at Tawny Town, and 300 to 350 in the larger centers. So that's huge. Our centers are growing.
So when you have, first of all, the age. Let's talk about that.
Okay.
Is there a minimum age or not?
Through Older Americans Act funding, we fund our meals, and that's age 60 and over.
Okay.
So we do age 60 and over for most of our programs. If someone's disabled and age 50, they can join us.
Okay. And there is a process.
There is a process.
Certainly you can walk in the door and do it here and register, but that you like for folks to register to...
We have to have registration because of our federal funding. So they just have to fill out a form, and they can go, from filling out that form, they get a little card, and there's a touch screen. So when they come in, they touch the activities that they're doing, which helps us keep track of everything. And they can use any of the 5 senior centers. So we have many people that move from center to center.
See, now that's something I didn't know either.
Right.
So how often, Celine, so you're new, you came on board here. You guys travel around to each of the 5 on a pretty regular basis just to see what's going on and to keep track of things, I guess?
We do, and I wish we could get out more because we have so many activities that go on at the centers. Last month we had celebrated Older Americans Month. I was out at South Carroll Senior Center for that celebration. It was fantastic because they had done a board where people did write-ups about how they were aging out loud, because the idea of aging and what it means today is very different from what it meant 50 years ago.
Yeah.
The encouragement for people to be active, to be independent, to still maintain their own bills, their own lifestyle, continue to do their own household chores, because we know that staying active helps you to maintain your independence. And that is ultimately what we want, and also to help people age in their own homes rather than moving into a facility, because what we've realized is no one wants that. And that's our goal with the Bureau.
And that's a great segue into my next question, which is, you know, let's talk about stereotyping these buildings. Folks, think about the fact that they're nursing home type facilities, right, if you will. That's the furthest thing from the truth that could ever be with these senior centers.
Correct.
And it's because of the activities that are involved here. Just touch quickly on...
Well, we have so many physical activities, and we're lucky that Koons Toyota is a great sponsor for us, and every year they give us a very generous donation so that folks can give a donation to take a class as opposed to paying for the class. And so we're able to offer many, many physical activity classes, and I watch them, and there's some I couldn't keep up with. So we have anything from a very basic chair exercise, arthritis exercise, we have yoga, tai chi, all kinds of dance, ballroom dance, line dance, we even have belly dance classes.
Wow.
There's just so much going on in the centers, Zumba Gold, so it just, the physical activity classes are probably our biggest by far. We have fitness rooms in every one of the centers with treadmills, bikes, weight-bearing equipment,
right,
heavily used. So we're very fortunate. In addition, we have educational classes. The college pairs up with us and comes in and teaches art classes.
Mm-hmm.
They teach computer classes for us. So we have many great, Mount Airy offers Spanish classes. So there's some great, great activities. Westminster has a huge stained glass class that meets several times a week. Woodworking is big at North Carroll, huge at North Carroll. In fact, we've run out of space and they take turns using the woodworking room.
Right.
Wood carving. There's so many things. Classes, in addition to the cards, the billiards, the bingo,
right,
that people
right,
always
right.
think you go to a senior center and play bingo. That's probably
yeah.
one of the smallest activities that we have in our centers.
Yeah, although I got to say, I called bingo up at the North Carroll Senior
right.
Center a couple, I don't know, it's been a few months ago,
mm-hmm.
and that place was jammed.
It
there,
is.
There wasn't
it
a
is.
Seat in the house.
It is.
And as a matter of fact, there's an extra room in the back of that
mm-hmm.
main room,
mm-hmm.
and they were sitting in there.
It's just good grief. And another thing people don't realize is we have an average attendance about 600 a day in senior centers. The smaller centers
wow.
have less. There might be 50 average here. The larger centers can be up to 150 people a day. That's a lot of people moving through the buildings.
Unbelievable. Meals. Let's quickly go on meals because we're going to be running out of time here because
okay.
we could talk about this all you know. This could be an hour episode.
Right.
The meals we offer to...
So the meals we offer to folks, people that are age 60 and over can come in and they can make a donation for the meal, what they're able to afford.
Mm-hmm.
We serve those on a daily basis, Monday through Friday. We also offer meals to folks with a disability that come in and they would have to pay the full price of the meal. But it's very reasonable, and we offer those at all five centers 5 days a week, and we serve almost 40,000 meals a year to individuals that come into our centers, which
wow.
is a phenomenal number, and that is thanks to Patty and her staff
do a
fantastic job.
By the way, I've had a meal or two.
They're good.
Pretty good.
They are good.
I gotta say.
They are good. We have we serve an average of 160 meals a day.
Yeah.
15 in the smaller centers. Westminster is about 70 every day. It's
yeah.
And we have many people that need these meals, and so.
It's kind of twofold when
yes.
you know. You're
right.
providing a great service, but yet it's something that's critically
right.
needed. So
well, and the socialization is huge.
Yeah.
So
well,
to get folks to come into a meal and to build friendships makes a
yeah,
huge
and
difference
see that's
in
the
their
key
life.
Too. You know, we talk about as one of the county commissioners, I talk about it a lot with my colleagues about aging in place, and
mm-hmm.
Celine, you touched on that a little bit about how important that is, and there's no mystery that happens in Carroll, and we've got a huge population of mm-hmm. aging in place folks.
Yes.
And you know, one of the things to remember is you're not alone out there, and these senior centers provide the perfect opportunity for folks to interact, gosh, meet a neighbor that they probably hadn't met before,
right.
You know, whatever it is, and to get out of the house and you know, and be able to get here. Transportation, let me touch on that.
Okay.
Real quick. Certainly we've got the CTS in Carroll County.
Right.
That's our transportation system. Regular stops here at the senior centers, right? All five
right.
of them.
And if they call CTS, they can come to a senior center for $2 each way. So
okay.
that's a special deal we get
right.
For people that want to come into the senior centers for the day.
Excellent. Patty, how long have you been with the county?
Going on 16 years in September.
You're not going anywhere anytime soon.
Not anytime
We're
soon.
Not letting her.
Yeah. And Celine, you've been with the county for
5 years.
Yeah. So, well, we're gonna have some footage here of this center.
Okay.
And we'll walk around here and show. We're actually in the library here, which
right.
Again, you know, there's another little perk. They've got most. Do they all have their library? They're in
library. They all have libraries.
See that?
There's
so,
lots of books to borrow, as you
yeah.
can see.
So, good grief! You know, again, something that folks probably
right.
don't realize.
Right.
So.
And once a month, we usually have specials in the centers. Today, when you walk around, you're going to see we're having a retirement party.
Right.
For our manager, we have a brand new manager that's been with us for a week, but. We tie them into our special meals. So last week was Older Americans, and we had 500 people attend these meals in the senior centers for that day.
You know, your numbers are, I mean,
right.
off the charts. They mm-hmm. really are. And that's the one reason I wanted to get out here today and put this out that, look, you know, you're not coming in here to sit in a wheelchair. You're,
right.
This is activity-filled buildings.
Oh.
That are just off the
Absolutely.
Charts with stuff, all
Absolutely.
Kinds of stuff. Let's just, let's,
right.
you know,
and there's
call
something
it what
for
it
everyone,
is.
And if there isn't, tell us and we'll
And you'll
get
do it.
It.
And we have developed partnerships with the local health department, Carroll Hospital Center, Access Carroll. We have them come in and provide educational opportunities to our folks throughout the months. And we highlight the hottest topics in disease. We focus on skin cancer, breast cancer. We also focus on diabetes, heart problems, and we focus on ideas and activities that can help them with not only prevention, but also connecting them to resources if they need to actually go in for treatment. We provide screenings in the center as well, and we also provide legal aid for people that need assistance with assessing, you know, estate planning, living wills, advance directives, and we work with all of those options for folks, and that's on a monthly basis. So please, we're also a gatekeeper for connecting them with other resources at our centers, and it's a fantastic opportunity that we give to people. And if you've not ever visited a center, I would recommend to folks out there, please do so.
So, phone numbers that they can call, websites that they can visit to get in touch.
Well, if they visit the Carroll County government website,
okay,
all they need to do is click on senior centers, and each senior center has a category, and they have their newsletters, which are
okay.
huge.
All right.
Have the meals, have the schedule of events.
Okay.
To call the Bureau of Aging for services, 410-386-3800.
Okay.
And each senior center's phone number will be listed in their newsletter and on the website.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Well, the bottom line here is this. These buildings have just an incredible wealth of opportunity for our senior population.
Absolutely.
And you know, I would encourage folks that are maybe on that fence, whether or not they, you know, they want to get out more and interact, and they are aging in place. What a great place to be.
We have wonderful volunteer opportunities.
Well, yeah, so
we
there's
have
that,
450
right.
volunteers because we only have two staff in each center. So
okay. So there's
they gave us 56,000 hours last year of help.
Wow.
So even if you don't want to participate in activity, volunteer.
Come out
you know?
And volunteer. Yeah, that's another great point because it might get folks to become involved that wouldn't
right.
necessarily want to be part of
right.
that faction of folks that takes advantage of some right. of those things, but yet they can come in and help. Tremendous. All right, that number again for the Bureau of Aging is
410-386-3800.
Very good. And you can get onto the Carroll County government webpage and go to the Senior Centers link and it'll take you wherever and show you these places. We're going to show you some footage of this senior center, but I want to thank you two guys. First of all, I know what your passion's like, Patty, because you've been involved in this for a long time.
Yes.
And it's complemented extremely well by Celine, because I see her passion here too. Mm-hmm. And that's your background, right?
Correct.
So perfect fit for you. So y'all do an incredible job, and we're blessed to be able to have, I mean, I say this all the time, we got fantastic staff in Carroll. So
we do.
Thank you very much for all that you guys do, and keeping these places up and running and providing the opportunity for our folks is just incredible. It really is. So we're going to show some footage from this facility. And again, thank you all.
Thank you.
Welcome back, Keeping It Real in Carroll. It's a great place to start our programming again in one of our fantastic, I don't want to call them hidden gems, because maybe they are a little bit,
right,
but let's get it out there so they're not. But the Tawnytown Senior Center and all five senior centers that provide great opportunities for our aging in place folks. Thank you very much, and we'll catch you on the next episode of Keeping It Real in Carroll.